So it turns out that when you buy a cinema camera, you have to buy a lot more shit than expected. Today, I'm gonna go over the whole list of add-ons to the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K that I personally use to make this handheld rig work for my needs. All right, so first up, we have the Magic Rig Cage. I got this on Amazon along with the rubber grip handle for I think around 70 bucks. And the cage does two things. It offers the camera body a little bit of protection, and there are like a billion threads where you could screw in anything you want. But I'm only using two of them to screw in this mount for my external SSD. Now, why record externally to an SSD instead of just using a memory card? The external SSD is just the most cost-efficient way that I've found to record these huge RAW file sizes without running out of storage too quickly. Now, since Blackmagic RAW does have some pretty efficient compression ratios, you can record on an SD card. When you calculate the cost to storage ratio, SSDs are going to be the way to go in terms of saving you money. The Pocket 4K doesn't have a flip-out screen, so that's why I use an external monitor. To power up the monitor and the Pocket 4K, I use this battery bank. Now, the battery bank comes with a 2-to-1 splitter, two male ends to one female. So that's three connections: the battery, the monitor, and the camera body. If you're going to be on shoots that require long battery life, I highly suggest any type of external battery as opposed to the battery that comes stock with the camera. The Pocket 4K comes with this Canon LPE6 battery, and in my experience, it lasts only for about 40 minutes. For someone like me who shoots real estate, interviews, and documentaries, I won't always be able to switch out batteries whenever I have to. This battery bank powers my external monitor and the Pocket 4K for about 2.5 hours. Now, in order to make the Pocket 4K compatible with the battery bank, I had to kind of hack the power cable. On the side of the camera, there is going to be an input for a 12 volt source. The problem is the power cable that comes with the camera is attached to a wall adapter, and you can't plug this into a battery bank. So I had to do some cutting, and I had to solder the DC plug end of that cable to these pigtails, specifically this male end, so that way it could plug into the battery bank. And lastly, since the Pocket 4K has a Micro Four Thirds sensor, I had to use an adapter, but an adapter that's specifically a speed booster. The speed booster I chose was the Viltrox EFM2 version 2. Simply because it was cheaper than the Metabones. It's giving me a little bit of extra light because it's focusing all that light into that smaller sensor area. And secondly, it's counteracting that crop that I would have when I used my full frame or APS-C lenses on a Micro Four Thirds sensor. So my final crop factor is going to be very similar to what I have been using on all my APS-C cameras. My gimbal rig with the Pocket 4K doesn't look much different than this, other than I removed the handle so it's not so top heavy, and the monitor and battery are mounted on the gimbal itself with that O-ring. Because of how awkwardly shaped the camera is, it's very difficult for me to get perfect balance on my Zion Crane 2. But by keeping the cage on there and making the overall setup heavier, I can justify setting my motors to high, and doing it that way has gotten rid of all the vibrations that was going on. I'm probably pushing the motors a little bit harder than I have to, but as long as I get the shot, I guess it's okay. Anyway, be sure to check out the description below. I have all kinds of goodies down there. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you guys next time.
Peace.